Open the Visual Studio and run as administrator mode. Here I opened my Visual Studio in administration mode. See here, it is the administrator. Now we are going to discuss about how to create a model in D365. So here what you have to do here is go to the Dynamics 365. Here it will be appear. Here we will have multiple options. Go to the model management. Here we have options: create a models, refresh models, update model parameters, view package, all package dependencies. Here I am going to create new model. Select the create new model, create a model. Click on create a model. Here we can enter the model name whatever we want. I will give here name is now test POC. See here, next button is not enabled, so we need to give the publishers also. I will give publisher is test POC. Here I'll keep it the layer is the user layer. See here, layer concept is same as per 2012. Every layer has the patch layer. Every base layer has patch layer, and all the layers it came from the 2012. Okay. Here we can give the version number, and here we can give model description, whatever you can. So go to the next. So here we have the multiple options. One is create new package, another one is select existing package. So I am creating new one, so I am selecting the create new package. So here we have the multiple options, and they given the descriptions. As per description also we can go ahead. If you giving the select existing package, we can see these many. So these are coming from D365. Okay, so I will select create new package and click on next. So by default it is selected the application platform, and we can see the different kinds of models here. So whatever model is required, we can tick the checkbox. Okay, so like this it will be there. So my model has the reference for this specific model, so I can use this model objects into the my model. I can use, okay, click on next. It will give the summary like this. Here we have the two checkboxes. One is create new project, another one is make this my default model for new project. So click on finish. It will create the new project. It is created the project like this. Okay, whatever objects you need to add, you can add from here. Right click, so add new items. So it will give you what item you need to add. Those you can add it. So what will happen exactly if we are creating the project, creating the new model? Okay, our service folder, package local directory. Here we have information for the all the models. Okay, so my model name is test POC. See here my model is there. If I open here, I can see descriptor file test POC XPP metadata. No files I can see. Nothing is there. If I am going to the descriptor file, here I will have the one file that is called descriptor file. So when I am showing into the while creating the model, I have selected the package local directory. Oh no, sorry, application platform, I guess. Okay. So we can open as a XML format, or if you are directly clicking on edit, it will display as a text notepad. So see here, this is the information, applied updates, nothing, and the customizations allow, descriptor here nothing is there, display name test POC, every model has some ID, this is the ID number, and my layer number is 14, locked false. Okay, here we have the model module is the test POC, and model reference. In this reference, whatever I can select the packages, I can see here. Model references started here and ended here. Module reference. Okay, module references started here and ended here. And these are, we can easily manage these things. And my very important thing is this property, module references and customizations allow and locked false. If you are putting log true is, it doesn't allow to edit the your objects. Okay, so this is the way we can do it. So while creating the model, after creating the model from Visual Studio D365, it will create one folder in backend in AWS service package local directory. You can see here, this is the way creating the module.